Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice.
Hello, world to Reese's tune. Tracks and fat up issues over Sarah's and Beetlejuice. In Beetlejuice view, I'm speaking proof of that Jesus dude. Just listen, yeah, and see me through. I stand by my lonesome, I don't need a group. But don't take me for a sight, cause I'm gonna be an arsehole if you need me to. Cause what me you say, me you do. I've got issues I don't really wanna get too deep into. Like getting a hard on when I'm beating you. It's elementary, like trees in woods or beef in stew. But what do you expect by trying to fuck me like Reese the Groom? Amazing me, you must never cease to. It's as clear as day when you can still see the moon down. You're artificial, like freezing food, and saying that really is needless too. But for a bloke, you're a weak excuse. Knowing fuck all like the weekly news. Bollocks knacks, I'm in a fucking creepy mood. So it's nothing but grief and feud. To a horror movie, this is a sequel too. In your bedroom, Keo, I'll be peeping through. Just when you close your eyes, I'll spring the fuck out. Hello, Bob, peek-a-boo. Anyway, let's change the subject, like eating food. Some sweets or fruit. Now, fuck that, cause I'll need a poo. What about the fact that I get so pissed I'll sleep in shoes? Or a question, mate, why people shoot? Let's ask these geezers who. Well, we reckon it's time to tell a story about some geezer I know. Simon is in his 40s, a little bit naughty. See, he's a serial killer and his occupation to him is very important. See, he pisses in the wind about caution. He cares about fuck all because he's sitting on his own little fortune. He invented some material called porcelain. Plus, he's got an internet site where he runs courses how to avoid the police forces on some race horses. But apart from the fact that he doesn't worry about expenses, like I said earlier, he has some tendencies. Look at him funny and he gets all offensive. Says, don't be all ever like Lensing. Pulls out his weapon and sits you on some benches and force feeds you a litre of antiseptic. I told you, this fella's demented. He doesn't like friendship, and the way he knows the law, he will always be undetected by the detectives on www.topmurderers.com. See, he's well respected. See, I reckon he's past his default, but the subject he never mentions. He was neglected as a kid, see, he was anorexic. Plus, he was bullied frequently by Frederick. He used to beat him with that lead stick shot. But now the seasons change. No more freezing rain, so the reasons ain't the same. Hardly no grieving and pain leaking that brain. Cause every other day he meets Lorraine, a lovely sweet little dame. So now he's tamed. No more filling graves to find ways to ease the days. I'm pleased to say he's again Reese's mate. But wait, let me tell you about last Tuesday and what happened while Simon was napping. Lorraine smothered his face with some cellophane wrapping because he turned and gave her a good old slapping. Called her ugly and said she was a fat thing and she wasn't attractive. It's a fucking shame because he was just adapting. Perhaps him should have thought before reacting. Then his bodily functions would have been collapsing. But I suppose the good thing is there'll be no more bodies found cut up in a black bin. Rest in peace, Simon, mate. Ta-da!